The school shooting in Florida appears to be the event that will ultimately tip the scale in the war against the Second Amendment and firearm ownership. Politicians who defend the Second Amendment and argue the issue of mass shootings in America is a complex issue that doesn't have easy answers are being told they will be voted out of office if they don't back demands to outlaw firearms. The anti-Second Amendment movement is a classic example of Fabian socialist incrementalism. The Brady Raiders and Bloomberg's mayors won't stop at a more intrusive background check system. It's encouraging to see young people once again becoming politically active. However, unlike their predecessors in the 1960s and 70s, their focus on violence doesn't include the biggest purveyor of violence, the state. Meanwhile, the liberals busied themselves with the culture war and identity politics. In the background, the wars rolled on, and the media continued its war on terror propaganda campaign, portraying the murder of innocents in Syria, Afghanistan, Iraq, Pakistan, Libya, and Africa as a noble cause in the name of democracy. The number of people killed in U.S. wars, interventions, and proxy conflicts make Pol Pot, Kim Il-sung, Saddam Hussein, Sukarno, Mussolini, and various African dictators look like rank amateurs by way of comparison. And yet, the American people remain largely clueless. Thanks to a corporate propaganda media, reading from government scripts, and a public education system that doesn't educate, but rather indoctrinates, and trains the public to respect and obey the state. When the founders included the Second Amendment in the Bill of Rights, they understood the true nature of government and its impulse to control citizens and deprive them of their natural rights. Thank you.